This is Mama Pet and Rosie. Rosie's resting right now. Oh, I was looking through my journals and realized I need some work done on them. So I wanted to make some paper flowers for Lisa. Lisa is another nugget in my gold basket. She's, Lisa, G-O-M-M-E. Sorry, Gomi. Sorry, Lisa, I can't pronounce names good. But this is one of my journals. And I'm gonna make some flowers today. And I think I wanna put some in my journals. So I got two of my denim. I covered them with denim. And I got coffee dyed paper, Kool-Aid dyed paper, and then this burlap where I just put it in the copier, copied it. And I do a lot of that. When I need some paper and I don't have any with print on it, I just throw me some fabric in my copier and I just copy it out, scan it out. But anyway, to get to the flowers, this is the ones that I've done this morning. This one was a little bulky for my journal. And this is the same size as these in the height of them. So I'm gonna be making some more of these. And putting some bling on them. And what I did is I got me a magazine. Grab you an old magazine or an old book. It don't matter. Just so you got paper. You got writing paper that your kids, it's not using anymore. Like their notebooks they bring home at night, and if they have any scrap paper, grab it. Because these are junk journals, and they're for junk mail and junk and paper that a vintage photographs. And you can make albums, or you can make journals and put your photographs in it. But what I'm doing is I'm making mine where they can be written in, and putting a little few things like the flowers and the birds and the bees and the all that stuff to give it interest. When you make a journal or anything, you want to give it some interest. Okay, I'm doing the accordion fold. My sheet, my magazine page, I cut it in thirds, and I'm gonna do the accordion fold. And with the little one, after I did this one, I cut it in half. My back's feeling better today. I can talk a little bit better. God's blessed me. I just thank every one of you for all your prayers. God is listening to us. He hears our prayers. Sometimes we don't think He does, but we do. He does. He hears every prayer we pray. And sometimes we may not think that He's on time. But He may not be on time for us. But He's never late. Okay, I cut it in half. And then I made my little slot there. Then I'm going to lay them together so they'll both go the same way. I'm going to make sure that they're the same. So I'm going to cut that one down a little bit. Okay, then I'm going to put the thick Elmer's glue. Right here. I'm going to put this. Whoops, got it upside down again. You have to use all your fingers to do this because it'll jump out of your hand. Okay, we got glue over there. Glue over here. And then we're just going to flip it over. Flip it over to where it'll meet on the other side. Let's get it together. You don't want one higher than the other. Like this. Right now, this is the point, so you want it pointed out. You want your points pointed out. So pull your center in. And you want to have your piece of cardboard ready to glue. Mama Pat's cardboard runs away. All of her stuff just runs right up under her hand sometimes. Okay, and then I'm gonna put my glue on the cardboard. That back together. Pick it up and turn it over. Have to use all your fingers. Unless you got somebody to help you. And Rosie's busy right now. Rosie's got to take a nap. So she can't help Mom Pat. And I don't have nobody else to help me. So I'll just have to hold it for a few minutes. You have to hold it until it sits up. This is one. This is one. This is one. Now these are a little different than these. I'll show you how to make these. But to put them in your journal, you would have to have a good place where you could use book. Because these are pretty high. And I don't know about trimming them. And this one I trimmed down some, but I messed it up when I was trimming it. And I don't like that dark color in there. I like these magazine pages where they got the different colors. Makes them real pretty. Makes the flowers pretty. Okay, let's see if that's gonna fold. Nope, that's not gonna hold. Let's put some more glue on it. This one's pretty. I like that green. Now you can touch them up with paint, or you can put different things on them. I got these little rhinestone looking things. I call them my diamonds, because they look like diamonds. But I got a box full of them from Walmart. In different sizes. I think there's 4 or 5 different sizes in there. And I think they'd be pretty on top of these. And they'll match about anything. So wherever you put them. And I think we need our hot glue gun to put them on with. Probably would hurt. Probably better to use hot glue gun or cardboard too. If you got one, if you don't, just use what you got. See, if you don't have glue, mix you up some flour and water. Make sure your water's good and hot. Make sure you mix your flour up real good. Don't you have clumps in it. You want some real good glue? Put your flour and water on your stove and cook it a little bit until it gets just a little bit thickness. Okay, the hot glue gun's getting hot. My laptop went out. It's still under warranty, so my son's taking it back to the shop or to the place where I bought it, and I can make a hour video, 30 minutes or an hour video on my laptop, but on my phone I can only make 14 minutes, and 14 minutes is not much at all. So I try to keep my I try to keep watching out, because lately I've had a couple of videos that went out without me saying bye. So if it happens, you'll know why. I'll try not to let it happen. Okay, I put hot glue on there. It set up quicker. That helps Mom and Pat, because it's hard for me to hold on to anything little. My small motor skills is not functioning right. Okay, that's one flower. Now there's several different kinds of flowers, and as I go along, put my journal together, I'll make different ones so if you stick with me, you see me putting my journal together. The way I do it now,